What's up, everyone? It's TyranitarTube, and welcome back to another Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire video. Now, before I say anything, can you believe it's June? It felt like X and Y came out not too long ago, but that was nearly 7 months ago. Anyway, there isn't too much news going around for these new games, and like I've said in other videos, we're expecting a huge new spike at E3 just over a week away. Some fans think it'll just be simple gameplay, but I feel like they're gonna showcase a lot more, like additions to smaller things in the original games, like an underwater world and secret bases. I've already covered the speculations around a full-on underwater world, so it's time to take a look at what Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire will do to secret bases. If you don't know what a secret base is, it's a small area that can be created and personalized to your likings. You can't create these secret bases anywhere though. There are 75 set locations to use, each with a set design that you can add things to. Secret bases were a fun addition to the original games, but fans often dislike the fact that there are set locations and you couldn't make a secret base anywhere you wanted to. They also dislike the fact that secret bases had holes and obstacles that lowered your space and made over half of them unwanted by users. This is one of the smaller hopes for secret bases, being able to create your base anywhere that's reasonable, and you not being restricted by obstacles. Just imagine being able to create your base even underwater, it would be the ultimate hideout. If you remembered back in Pokemon Platinum, and even recently in Black 2 and White 2, we had features similar to secret bases. In Pokemon Platinum, you were given a villa in the resort area that you could customize with furniture, but you can't pick the locations of the furniture, and most of them are unusable. Similarly, in Black 2 and White 2, you had your own gate building called Joint Avenue to customize with shops, but you were limited to just that. But one thing to note aside from the huge limitations is that in-game NPCs came to visit your area, like gym leaders, the professor, and more. Just imagine walking into your secret base in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire and noticing a visitor. Picking up from this, maybe they can even make Hoenn gym leaders visit your base in order to challenge you or reward you. Now, my mind doesn't really speak for everyone, so to figure out what fans wanted to see in secret bases, I hosted an open poll on my Twitter and got some really interesting responses. The first, which many of you may be familiar with, is incorporating street paths with your secret bases. In the original Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald games, you could mix records with another Hoenn game through the use of a link cable and add their secret bases to your game. And once you find their base, you can battle the team that they last had when you mixed records with them. It was amazing to explore my brother's secret base in Emerald and wreck with my Tyranitar. But moving back, Street Pass has proven to work extremely well as seen with X and Y's Player Search System, or PSS. Imagine if you could tap on the icons of friends or passerbys and have the option to add their secret base to your world. Then just like in the original games, have the task of finding their base, exploring it, and battling their last team as a computer. Along with this, some fans suggest that there would be rewards linked with secret bases to give them a larger purpose. For example, they can make secret base shops very limited in items, with the ability to lock more as you find more secret bases and battle more trainers in their base. Maybe they could even incorporate friend safaris into the secret bases, with 3 Pokemon being available in each secret base. It would be such a great addition, and from what we saw in X and Y, it definitely looks like it's in reach. But that's all we can speculate for now. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like. Let me know what about secret bases you want to see in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. There's a lot more coverage to come, especially with E3 coming up, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. If you want to check out the underwater video I mentioned earlier, go ahead and check out the video on the right.